Hey guys, Nick Alpha here, and welcome back to Let's Play Pokemon Red. So, we're going to catch some more Pokemon in this episode. So, the ones to catch are Oddish and Abra. You get them both in the grass here. You'll want to use Sleep on Abra with your Butterfree, which will make him a lot easier to catch because he will teleport and escape instantly. Then after that, I will be demonstrating the Mew glitch, so I will be back soon. Okay, so I have caught both Oddish and Abra. I've kept Abra in the party, and I will leave Oddish back in someone's PC. So, right, let's get on with the Mew glitch. So, what we want to do is go to the spot that I'm at right now, and you want to press down and pause at the same time, like this, so he can't challenge you, and then you go into Pokemon and use Abra's teleport, and he should get an exclamation mark above his head. But we will teleport away. Okay, so we've now done that. So what we want to do is go to the gym, and I've put the wrong Pokemon in the head of the party, but we'll be fine. I'll just swap them out. So you take on the first trainer, and we want to beat them by using the best thing against water types is we're going to use Pikachu. So let's get someone who's not going to be wasted by water in on the battle. Okay, let's go with Thundershock, and we'll be grand. Well, that didn't go too well. Okay, let's stick with Pikachu and use another Thundershock. And this should be us. Boom! There we go. Okay, so now I want to leave here and head back to Nugget Bridge. So what will automatically happen when we get to Nugget Bridge is that the menu will open automatically, then when you press B, Mew will appear. So we want to put Butterfree to the head of the party. And battle for boss time, kind of. So there's our super rare Mew, level 7. We would probably destroy it, so I'm just going to use sleep powder and just keep throwing pokeballs at it. I should have stocked up in time to make sure we've got enough. I decided to buy 25 for my little expedition. But, so yeah, this is basically the process we're going to go through until we catch him. And this takes time. Okay, let's go with another sleep powder. If it doesn't happen in the next turn or two, I'll do it off screen and just show you me catching him. Okay, alright, I'll do this off screen. Okay, so there we go, we've caught Mew, and there it is, new species. Said to be a Mirage. So that's how you get what is essentially the ultimate Pokemon in the game really early on. It's pretty simple to do, just a bit of a nuisance to catch. I will not be using Mew in this game, and I will be playing it under the assumption that you won't be having him in your main party. If you fight a Pokemon and give him less than 54 experience, you can actually level him up to level 100 straight away. Which is pretty cool. So if you want to use them, by all means, go ahead. I will not. So I'm not going to go back to where I was before catching Mew and continue on with the story. Okay, so let's move on up to the east here on Route 25. And we're going to take on this hitchhiker here. So, let's put the spear up to the top and take him on. Oh, we've done the same. Oh, so there's a new Pokemon there, Machop. Just a normal fighting type, nothing to worry about. Always good to have the edge. Thought that was a solid hit we got from him. Let's see. Okay, let's put Butterfree up, and we're going to use Confusion. Oh man, I really got my money on that one. Okay, so we've beaten him and got another level. Alright. So now what we want to do is go here. Hit A to find a hidden elixir. So that's good. So, right, I'm going to go back and heal, and then I'll come back to take on the next hiker. Okay, so what I've actually done in the time between then is got my Abra up to level 18. Once you hit level 16, he evolves into Kadabra, who will be an absolute powerhouse for the entire game, and I will demonstrate that now. Just check this out. Ooh, yes, we are on our way to see Bill. Okay, let's use Confusion. Fortunately, he only learns Confusion at level 16 when he evolves, so you'll have to take quite a while to train him up, but yeah, look at that damage. So, let's move on to the next one, who is a youngster, and we want to swap in Geodude. Okay, let's just stick to Rock Throw, and that will get us through here. Let's stick to Geodude and keep using Rock Throw, we'll be fine. Oh yeah! There we go. Alright. Okay, so now I want to change to Pikachu. But as an added interesting side, this next kid there, you can do the Mew glitch on him as well. So you do exactly the same thing as last time, only instead of taking on the trainer in Cerulean Gym, you take on this guy, and yeah, that's an option then, but I'm not going to do that, but because we're on the route anyway, I'm going to take him on. The other trainer I will leave free in case I decide to use the Mew glitch for some reason, but right, let's take on this guy. Snowpoke. Pretty interesting little dude there. Generally accepted not to be a wonderful Pokemon, but you can actually get some pretty awesome stuff when you evolve him. And he becomes a lot more powerful in the later games. And obviously psychic moves. Very effective against most types, so... but we'll be okay. Alright, so next thing we want to do is take on this lass, and that's actually all I've got time for, so we'll take her on in the next episode. But will we be able to find Bill? And what will we find at his house if we do? Find out next time on Let's Play Pokemon Red. I'm Nick Alpha, take her easy.